FH is also called familial hypercholesterolemia, and it is a condition that results from the body's inability to clear high cholesterol from the blood. This results in startlingly high cholesterol levels. So an ideal cholesterol is less than 130 milligrams per deciliter, and in FH patients, generally we see an LDL cholesterol over 190, usually more like 220. And this very high cholesterol level is like a poison to the blood vessels. It results in huge accumulation of fatty deposits and cholesterol deposits in the arteries that feed the heart, and it leads to a much, much greater risk of heart attack or stroke. FH is a genetic condition. It's passed in families, and if one parent has it, then every child has a 50% chance of having FH. If you inherit a bad copy both from the mother and a bad copy from the father, that's called homozygous FH, and it's actually even more serious. If FH has been identified in a family, then every family member should be screened. The key about FH is that you have high cholesterol from the time you're born. So over the course of a life, your blood vessels are exposed to very high levels of cholesterol. And this really takes its toll on the arteries. It affects 1 in 500 people across the world, and it affects everybody about equally. It's estimated that there are 600,000 patients in the United States with FH. FH is diagnosed based on a series of tests, most importantly what your blood cholesterol level is, and then we augment that information with your family history and some physical exam findings that are specific for FH. One of them is called xanthomas, and these are cholesterol deposits that often happen in the tendons of the body, particularly around the elbows or the Achilles tendons. Or there can also be cholesterol deposits around the eyes called xanthelasmas. Based on these three factors, we can diagnose with great accuracy people with FH. Very rarely, but increasingly commonly, we use genetic testing to identify FH patients. The future for FH, I think, is going to be bright, because we're going to be able to identify through national screening efforts many more patients with FH and get them on the proper therapy. The other thing is the development of new therapies, and in fact several new drugs are going to be in front of the FDA in the next 6 months to a year that might potentially be approved that we'll be able to use. Stanford has been a center for FH care for over 30 years. We have the Familial Hypercholesterolemia Clinic, where we specialize in the diagnosis and treatment of people with FH. One of the key things that is involved in that is really not just taking care of the individual patient, but also trying to take care of the family members of individual patients. We have a full-time genetic counselor in the clinic, and we have formed the Stanford Center for Inherited Cardiovascular Disease, which is meant to bring an additional layer of expertise onto heart conditions that are genetic in nature. And we're very lucky at Stanford to have some of the best interventional cardiologists. And Stanford, for over 50 years, has been one of the leading centers for cardiac surgery in the country. FH is treated very aggressively. We treat patients with FH with medications, principally to lower their cholesterol levels, also with recommendations about diet and exercise. We have lots of patients, particularly young female patients, that have had heart attacks or strokes at an early age, and it's very important to identify those people early so they can start therapy and reduce their risk.